Hey everyone, hope you're doing good. In the last video, we went through all the tools in this section. And in this video, we're going to cover the rest of these toolbar tools. Before we get started, if you want to become a pro at animation, go ahead and like the video and subscribe to the channel. This tool you see here is the Select Bone tool, which lets you pick bones based on their names. For example, I'll select B3, and as you can see, it's now selected. Or you can select B2 or any other bone you want based on its name. In the next section, you can rename any bone. For example, I'll change the name of B2 to B44 or ASA or anything else you want. As you can see, B3 is still there in the Select Bone section, but B2 is gone and is changed to ASA. All right, let's move on to the next part. This option is called Lock Bone. To explain it better, I'll draw some new bones. If I select one of these bones and click Lock Bone, then go to frame 1 or beyond in the timeline and try to move it, you'll see that it doesn't move. But if the bone isn't locked, I can move it freely in any frame without any issues. Exactly like what you're seeing in the video. The next option is Lasso Mode. When it's enabled, instead of selecting bones like this, you can select them like this, as you see in the video. It's really useful in crowded areas. With a color option, you can set any color for your bones. It doesn't affect how the bones work, it's just for keeping your project organized. For example, you can color the hand bones one way and the leg bones another way. And if it's set to plain, it stays in the normal default mode of the software. The next option is Show Label. If you enable it, the name of each bone will be displayed underneath it, which helps keep things more organized in your project. As you can see, I just turned the labels on. The next option is Shy Bone, which is used to hide bones. Sometimes when a project has a lot of actions and you don't need to see all of them, you can use this option to hide the extra bones. You'll understand this better when working with actions. All right, let's move on to another project to explain End Flip. If I select a bone and then click End Flip, it will flip that bone and its child bones exactly like you see in the image. But if I select the same bone and click the Side Flip option, you'll see that it flips that bone and its child bones in a mirrored way. So, End Flip flips from the end, while Side Flip mirrors the flip. The next option is Link Bones, which can be really useful in many cases. To activate it, we go into a new tab where we've already created a project to save you some time. Keep in mind that Link Bones is used for pixel images that we want to rig, and it doesn't really make sense to use it for vectors. As you can see, when the bone is in normal mode and we move it, it distorts the image like this and pulls all the layers together. To fix this issue, we need to use Link Bones. The Link Bone option is disabled in normal mode, and to enable it, we have to go into our image layers. As you can see, it gets activated and we can use it now. Now we need to find each of the layers. For example, I want to find the layer related to the arm and link it to the bone on the arm. I'll do this for the other layers as well. Now, if we select the arm bone again and move it, you can see that the movement is much better than before, and it has a lot less impact on the other images. However, this method is outdated, and the purpose of teaching you this is to help you fully understand the software. In the upcoming sections, we'll teach you advanced rigging techniques, so don't forget to like and subscribe.